Hello everyone, welcome to another session on introducing literature, and we were discussing about the introduction of module 3, introduction part of module 3. And in my previous video I discussed with you how ideology works in by taking a scene from a Malayalam cinema. And now I'll discuss that from by taking two statements, okay, from a very famous English novel, Pride and Prejudice. There are so many novels which from which you can take statements like this, where there is a reflection of the society, or you can say ideology of the society, or ideology of the political context of the time. Okay, all these things are there. But I thought like I'll take something that is in fact written by a woman, first of all, and secondly a book that is pretty familiar to all of you. Clear with that? Though this is like it does not belong to our century, I thought like this is like a must read for all literature students. So I thought I'll take this example. So the scene is when Charlotte is telling Elizabeth about about Jane, how could Jane, it's her opinion, Charlotte's opinion, how could Jane win Bingsley. This is Bingley, this is the scene. Okay, the statement goes like this: when she is secure of him, there will be leisure for falling in love as much as she chooses. Okay, so this is a statement. When she is secure of him, there will be leisure for falling in love as much as she chooses. So if at all you want to fall in love, and the component of leisure is also like highly problematic here, the concept of leisure, nammade avuru endha parayna, the freedom, or you can the liberation, all these things are connected with what, you have to be secure with him. Okay, so it actually defines what your leisure, it actually defines what your the limit of your love, or against the limitlessness of your love. All these things are determined by what you have to be secure of him. You can enjoy your freedom. This is what the society, even after two centuries, the society is telling us the same thing right now. You can have all fun, you can have all freedom, but first of all you have to get married. It's evident or clear, like in another statement where Elizabeth is in fact telling Darcy. Now I know when we look into the book Pride and Prejudice, one thing that we have to keep in mind is like all the decisions in the book are done by men. Okay, then women normally go for all the subordinate roles which are inferior to men, that are the roles that are taken by women in the book. And thirdly, you can say marriage is considered as the essential thing for to secure a good future for women, like or you can say something that is a necessity for women, women's future. Clear with that? So this is the message that is conveyed by the book. Okay, so even after two centuries, we are not much far away from this particular concept. But a woman has in fact written the book, and yet she says like this. This is like highly political thing. And at that particular context, we are in fact directed to the concept of, we are directed to the concept of ideology of the society. ആ ഒരു സമയത്ത് ഇതിനപ്പുറത്തേക്ക് വേറെ ഒന്നും പറയാൻ പറ്റുന്നുണ്ടായിരുന്നില്ല ഫോർക്കും ഫോർ ജെയ്ൻ ഓസ്റ്റൻ. ക്ലിയർ വിത്ത് ദാറ്റ്? സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദി ഐഡിയ. സോ ഇൻ ഇൻ അറ്റ് എ പോയിന്റ് യു ക്യാൻ സേ എലിസബത്ത് ഇസ് മേക്കിംഗ് ദ സ്റ്റേറ്റ്മെന്റ് ടു ഡാർസി, ഐ എം നോ ലോങ്ങർ സർപ്രൈസ് ഇറ്റ് യുവർ നോയിങ് ഓൺലി 6 അക്കംപ്ലിഷ്ഡ് വിമൻ. ഐ റാദർ വണ്ടർ നൗ അറ്റ് യുവർ നോയിങ് എനി. ഐ മീൻ ആറ് പേരെ തനിക്ക് അറിയാമെന്നുള്ളതല്ല എൻ്റെ പ്രശ്നം, ഒരാളെങ്കിലും ശരിക്കും അറിയും. ദിസ് ഇസ് ലൈക്ക് എ ഹൈലി ഐറോണിക്കൽ സ്റ്റേറ്റ്മെൻറ്റ്. I'll discuss in my next video. I'll discuss with you what exactly you mean by, we have discussed the three concepts here: irony, sarcasm, and dark humor that is mentioned in your textbook. Okay, so from this particular statement, it is almost clear for us. What is clear? It is almost clear for us that he explains in just a few sentences prior to this particular statement, he explains high standards he has for women and the skills he expects them to possess. But indirectly, all these are a kind of reinforcement of the sexist stereotypes of women. That is what we have to understand. Clear with that? So this is the ideology of the period that is getting reflected in the book. Clear? So it is not just about what, it is not just about the words that are mentioned up here. Okay. There are so many other things that are in fact get communicated in every discourse in the text, in every word that this discourse is like a heavy term, which I'll discuss later. Okay, so in every such instance, we are getting reminded of the fact that it is not just the author who is speaking. His cultural background, his historical context, his political background, the society of the time, the place where he is born in, he or she is born into, all these things in a way contribute to what? To the idea that is discussed in the text. Thereby, what we have to understand, what we have to understand is that there is an ideology that is getting reflected in every literary work. Clear with that? So we'll come back to the text. How literature or literary or cultural text means, there are so many cultural performances. If you look into, for example, from the context of Kerala, if you look into Theyyam, it conveys it's a text. Okay, text means something that has to be analyzed. Okay, so it conveys something, some meanings to the societal background, to the cultural background of our time. Likewise, you can say film is like a cultural text. Okay, so it speaks about certain things, that are there around us. Like it speaks about culture, culture, a broad definition to culture. Then, how literary and cultural texts conceal and interrogate power. How exactly they conceal power, in ways that are hidden, they act on us. I'll tell you, we'll discuss the concept of power in some other video. Okay, but there is a kind of a power that is at work. Clear with that? But power structures into the work of Ernandinath. Now they are telling us how a woman should be. They are telling us how a Dalit should behave in the society. They are telling us how a religious minority should behave in a society. ഇതൊക്കെ പറയുന്നുണ്ട്. എന്താണ് ഈ സൊസൈറ്റിയുടെ പവർ സ്ട്രക്ചേഴ്സ്, ദ സൊസൈറ്റി ഈ വിച്ച് ഇസ് ഇൻ ഫാക്ട് ബീങ് റൂൾഡ് ബൈ സം പവർ സ്ട്രക്ചേഴ്സ്. ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് ലൈക്ക് അബൌട്ട് ദ പൊളിറ്റിക്കൽ പവർ ഐ എം ടോക്കിംഗ് അബൌട്ട്. അതല്ല പറയുന്നത്. സൊസൈറ്റീനെ റൂൾ ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു പവർ സ്ട്രക്ചർ ഉണ്ട്, റിലിജനെ റൂൾ ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു പവർ സ്ട്രക്ചർ ഉണ്ട്. ദേ ആർ ടെല്ലിംഗ് അസ് ഹൗ എ വുമൻ ഷുഡ് ബിഹേവ് ഇൻ എ സൊസൈറ്റി, ഹൗ എ മാൻ ഷുഡ് ബിഹേവ് ഇൻ എ സൊസൈറ്റി, ഹൗ എ ചൈൽഡ് ഷുഡ് വർക്ക്, ഹൗ എ ഗ്രോൺ അപ്പ് ഷുഡ് വർക്ക്. Work in the sense, behave in a society. How you have to dress up, how you have to eat, what you have to eat. If you are a Malayali, you have to eat this. If you are an Indian, you have to do this. Likewise, so many things are designed by the power structures that actually exist in our society. Clear with that? Yes, so we will try to analyze that. Then how they privilege and strengthen dominant groups, how literature speaks for the dominant group. Likewise, how dominant group in a Kerala society, one example, dominant group is men, and that too upper caste men. Okay, be it Christian or Hindu or Muslim, whatever it is, upper caste and upper class men, they are a privileged group in Kerala society. So how this particular movie talks about their perception of women, you're getting it. So Then, so and strengthen the dominant groups and deprivilege and create the marginalized group. We'll try to do it, you know, through few examples or exercises. Then how they document, critique and subvert existing power relations. How they work on the existing power relations that are actually there in the society. That is what we are trying to analyze in this module. Yes, we'll meet in another video. Till then, take care.